Hi children, how are you? Once again I am here with you to discuss about the lesson The Treasure Within. Already I have explained few paragraph in the lesson and today I am going to continue with it. And I told you that every child has a treasure within him. That means every child is capable of doing something better or something big in his life. Only thing is that you have to recognize, you have to identify that you are good in what. Are you good in sports? Are you good in acting? Or are you good in singing? You have to find out. It doesn't mean that only the children who are good in academic field, only they are better. No children, it's not like that. Otherwise, Amitabh Bachchan, Sachin Tendulkar, Saurav Gangli, okay, and there are many who became very famous. Charlie Chaplin, he did not have a chance to go to school, but then he became a world famous actor. Okay, so only thing you have to do that you have to find out that what treasure is there inside you. Every child had this talent, but only thing they are not able to identify it at a right time. Maybe because they are not able to think when they are small. Otherwise, sometimes the pressure of parents are also there that no, you have to become engineer, you have to become doctor. So children, you have to show, you have to find out that you are interested in doing what. Okay, so in this lesson, Hafiz Contractor, though he was a very notorious child, he was very mischievous during the time of his school days. He never used to study. In fact, he used to pass by adopting the unfair means in the examination. But later on he realized, okay, one day he was watching someone. It was a house which was under construction that day. Now one of the contractor told that he was framing the window, he was making the window, but Hafiz was watching him. Suddenly he went to him and he told ki, if you will frame your window, if you will construct the window in this manner, the window will not open. Now children, the other fellow, he was shocked. He did not expected this thing from Hafiz. Now there was a bet between the two. He told, no, it will open. Hafiz told, it will not open. And finally Hafiz win. And children, then it was the husband of his cousin who prompted him, who forced him, who compelled him that he is having such a nice mind, why don't he go and study architecture. Now children, Hafiz was not good in maths at all. Taking the subject like architecture, in which maths plays a major role in that subject, at first he wanted to take his step behind, but then he thought it would be fun to construct the building. And finally he gave the entrance examination and he came with he got very good marks. So children, it doesn't mean the persons who are weak in earlier time. I was telling you in class 9th, I was teaching about Albert Einstein, the word genius person. Even his headmaster told him in the beginning that this child is very weak. In fact, he told his parent to take away the child, as I told you earlier also. But later on he had proved that he is a genius, and he had discovered that famous theory of relativity. He had given the formula E=mc² to the world. Okay, so that child who was not able to speak properly also, okay, when the mother told of Albert Einstein that he will not become anything, she did not see anything great in him when he was a child. That child, he had become the most celebrity of the world. He was given the title in the media as a scientific genius. So you also have to find that what treasure is there in you. So children, I was here on page number 27. Now there was an interview was going on. Did you remember between whom? The interviewer was Miss Bela Raja, and the person who was giving the interview is Mr. Hafiz Contractor. You can see his photograph also here. He is here sitting, and you can see how serious the child who was so notorious is looking so serious and genius in him. You can look at him. So now let's see what she's asking Bela Raja, Miss Bela Raja, what she's asking to her fizz. She told, when you were in school and you were doing badly, did your teachers pull you up and how did you feel? Now he told a simple answer to a simple question. He told, I never felt anything on being pulled up. I used to be so interested in playing, I would receive a caning every week. Oh yes, I did not tell you the last paragraph of page number 26. Now children, he did not even used to get passing marks. He used to pass anyhow sometime by adopting the unfair means in the examination. Though he was a very good sportsman, he had been the senior champion for so many years, and he was also the cricket captain, and he used to play every game. But that year when he was having examination, he did not step out into the field. I would go for prayers and all I would do was eat and study. Now children, when he was in the examination, okay, so he only stopped all his playing, and when he was in senior secondary school, okay, and he would only eat and study because the course is very vast. And still he felt I could not do that. Still he felt that he wouldn't be able to pass. But anyhow, when I got a second class 50% in my SSC, my principal said, son, consider yourself as having got a distinction. Now children, when he got 50%, in fact, he was thinking that he will never pass in that examination, though he stopped his playing. He only used to drink, he only used to eat and study. So only these two things were the part of his life. But he passed, though he got a less percentage. He got second division. He got only 50% marks. And the principal told him, son, consider yourself as having got a distinction. Distinction means more than 75% marks. Principal told, you were about to fail. You were so weak in studies, and passing SSC senior secondary school examination is not an easy thing to pass. It is a tough examination. So you consider yourself as if you have got distinction. This is my memory of my school days. I did lot of other things. See, as far as my things are concerned, I can't remember. Now he told you he used to do many things. So many things he used to do that he cannot remember now at this time of interview. I forget things very easily. To remember, I have to see things as a photograph. Now he told me, I often forget. This is my habit, to forget the things. And if I have to remember the thing, I have to go through the photographs. I read a book and I can remember the matter as a photograph, but not through my mind at it how it's work. Now children, he tells me he read the books, but the portion which he has to memorize, that he could memorize not by the words, by which the photograph which are there in the book. So this is how his mind used to work. Now Bela Raja, Miss Bela Raja is asking, when you were in school and you were doing badly, did the teachers pull you up and how did you feel? Now Bela Raja to ask him that, when you were doing badly, did the teacher used to scold you? And after getting the scolding, how you used to feel? I never felt anything on being pulled up. He told me, I never used to feel bad. I used to be so interested in playing, I would receive a caning every week. He knew that he was so much interested in playing. He did not like to study. And when it was the time of giving the assignment, he used to receive caning. And that has become the part of life. Every week he has to see all this thing. When you know that you had incurred the wrath of your teacher by not doing your homework, or by behaving badly, when you knew you would get a caning, what was the state of your mind? Now children, wrath is the anger. Now he told, when you know that your teacher is very angry, when you came to know this thing that your teacher is angry, then what used to do? How used to feel. Now let's see what he answer. And incur the wrath means rouse the anger. Now one question, very interesting question was asked to him, that Mrs. Bela Raja, she told that when so a nice question was asked to him, that when you knew that you had incurred the wrath of your teacher, incurred the wrath means that you have aroused anger in your teacher by not doing your homework or by behaving very badly. When you knew you would get a caning, what was the state of your mind? A state of mind, just lift up the hand and they would cane you. Now I used to tell nothing, I simply used to lift my hand up and they would start caning. It would hurt badly and then I would have to forget about it. Then he told ki definitely I used to get a hurt in my hand because he used to cane badly, but then after all I don't have any alternative to forget about it, because he really came to the school for playing. He did not want to study, so simply he would run and go and play. You never felt insecure or threatened? I was just interested in playing and nothing else. I was most interested in funny prank. So prank means mischievous activity. So he told ki I was rather interested in doing all the mischievous activity. Okay. So I never used to feel insecure or threatened. One day I did not want to study, so I created a distraction. For one whole hour we played chor police. Now he is describing, okay, he is telling that one day I did not want to study at all, so I created a distraction. That means he had debated everybody. Distraction means something amusing and pleasure. And then he started playing chor police. Chor police is a children game in which one child hires an other, the policeman who, the children who are policemen try to find that child. So he used to had a lot of fun during the school time. Every Saturday we were allowed to go into town to see a movie. And children, every Saturday they were allowed to go into the town and they used to watch movie. So what I would do was have no lunch and collect money from 40 to 50 students and run and buy the tickets. Now he never used to have lunch at that time, and he used to collect money from 40 to 50 students and run and buy the tickets. On my way back, I would eat to my heart's content. And children, the money which he was saved, he would eat to my heart content. That means he would eat as much as he wanted. He was satisfied with whatever he had eaten. I used to be the leader of a gang. No doubt, no good in studies, but at the same time he was accepted as the leader of the gang, because like he used to run and buy the tickets for the students and he used to distract the classes, so everybody liked him. We would have gang fights and plan strategies. Now he also told that sometime there used to be a gang fight, that means two group of students used to fight. And he was the one who planned strategies. Strategies means method of winning fight, that how their team should win the fight. These things used to interest me more than any academic. He told ki this thing used to interest me. He was rather interested in all this thing in the school rather to study. Now children, see how honestly and frankly he is telling about himself. A student used to book my textbook for the following year because they were almost brand new. Children, why brand new? Because whole year he never used to touch book. He never used to study. So his book was very much clean and neat. Okay, properly covered, because he never used to study the whole year without book. He was rather interested in playing pranks on other, making fun. Okay. I probably opened them one day before examination. So dad book he used to open only for the examination. So definitely his book used to be very neat and this thing, what to say, very no dots, nothing. Okay, so at the end of the year, the students were interested to buy his books because they are almost new. Now children, we will go to the second part. He stumbled on architecture because he knew little French and less German. He was offbeat. Offbeat means unusual or unconventional. Okay. So, stumble means he discovered by chance on architecture because he knew very little French and less German. He was offbeat even in the pranks that he played on other. Offbeat is, what did I told you, unusual or unconventional. That means whatever mischievous thing we used to do, it was something new. It was not a common mischievous that other children used to do. When he found his calling, there was no looking back. Okay. So now the second part of the lesson. Now Miss Bela Raja is asking, how did you get into the field of architecture? Now why he was interviewed? Because he was one of the most famous architecture, not only in Mumbai but in India. So he's telling, now learn the first part, his schooling, his mischievous things in the school and how he used to pass, all this thing was described. Now in the second part, something related with the architecture, as he was a very famous architecture, is we will know about this part about Hafiz contractor through this interview. So now Miss Bela Raja is asking, how did you get into the field of architecture? Now Hafiz contractor is replying, in the college for architecture, nobody who had got below 80-85% was allowed to enter. Now children, that college for architecture, definitely architecture is a tough subject as the maths is its base. So the admission used to be held there was through merit. So the student who had got below 80-85%, nobody who got below 80-85% was allowed to enter in the college. I had only 50%. I wanted to join the army. I got my admission later, but my aunt tore it up. Now children, his wish was to join army. He got the admission letter, but my aunt tore it up, and then I decided I wanted to join the police. But then later his parents did not allow, his aunt tore up the admission form. Now he decided that he would join the police force, but my mother said, don't join the police force, just do your graduation. So it was a wish of his mother that he should not join police force also, first he should finish his graduation. That means after the senior secondary, there is a 3 years course in graduation. Now he went to Jai Hind College in Mumbai. So where he went for his graduation degree, he went to Jai Hind College in Mumbai. That means at that time it was known as Bombay. There I was to either take French or German. Now children, in that college, the two language was a must. Okay, either a poor child has to study French or German. Though I did study French for 7 years, I did not know 7 words of French. Now children, he had taken French for 7 years, but he did not know even an ABC of French. He did not know even 7 words of French. So I took German. Then my German teacher died. Then children, he had to take German language, but unfortunately his German teacher died. The college told me that I could change the college or take French. Now the college, and there was no option. So the college told him, either you take the French or you continue with your, either you change the college or you take the French, because there's nobody who can teach you German now. Now, who would get me admission in that another quarter? After studying for a whole year, now he was thinking that who would give him admission at the last month when the examination is near. I had got admission to Jehand by influence. And children, he was not a good student. Okay, he got only 50% mark, did you remember? So through somebody's influence only he got admission there. So I thought, okay, I will take French, and I started learning French again. So he had no option. He knew that it would be very difficult for him to get admission in some other college, and that in Jehand college also through some source he got admission. So it is, he thought that it would be better if he will take French, and he started learning French again. I learned it from my cousin. She was an architect's wife. Now children, that French language he had taken the help of her cousin. Okay, she was a cousin's sister and her husband was an architect. I was going to an architect office to learn French. Now he used to go to her cousin's sister's husband's office, so that she used to come there in the office. So he used to sit for long hours and he studied French with the help of her cousin's sister. She started teaching French regularly to him, and he used to go to the architect office. Now who was architect? Her cousin's sister husband was an architect. Was it then that you decided you wanted to do architecture? Now Miss Bela Rajas, then that was at that time you decided that you wanted to do architecture. Hafiz contractor. Actually it all happened quite by chance. So Hafiz told, no, it was not like that. It only happened by chance. Now he told about an incident. He told, in the architect office I saw somebody drawing a window detail. Now he told ki in the architect office, children, what is an architect? They draw a map of the house. Okay, an architect is an expert. When a person construct their house, they go to the architect for the map, that the where should be the toilet, where should be the this kitchen, where should the, in which place the door would be set suitable for a room or a ventilation system or a drainage system. So they take the help of the architect. So one day he was drawing the map, and this architect, first they draw a map, they plan a map of the house, they draw it, and then that map is being discussed, and if the other person like it, then the house started, then this house start to be constructed. So one day he was drawing a map, okay, and he was showing that where that window would be. He was also drawing the windows at that time. That architect has to tell that where the door should be there, where the window should be there, all that thing he had to tell. So he saw somebody's drawing windows detail. A window detail is a very advanced drawing. Now children, window detail is a very advanced drawing. That means children, a person, an architect has to see that the window is in right place or not, whether a proper ventilation system or a light or a sunlight will come inside the room or not. So this he had to see it very carefully before drawing a map. So that person was also drawing the window detail. I told him, he was watching. Now Hafiz was sitting and he was watching him, and I told him that his drawing was wrong, that the window he had drawn would not open. Now due to some reason, the point where he was drawing the window, Hafiz told ki that you have taken the wrong point. If you will plan a window there, and if you will construct the house, the window will not open properly. He then had a bet with me, and later he found that indeed his drawing was wrong. And children, this his cousin, his sister, husband, he was sitting. So they both had a bet. Okay. Hafiz told ki no, the window will not open. The person who was drawing the window detail. That drawing proved to be wrong. Now that person, he studied architecture, and he, half his cousin, he did not even know the ABC of architecture. So the cousin's husband was very much surprised. He asked me to draw a few specific things, which I immediately did. Now he gave him some thing and he told to draw that thing related with the house. Now he drew, okay, in a very perfect manner. So what he asked me to design a house, and I designed a house. After that, he told me to drop everything and join architecture. Now children, the manner he had designed, he had planned the house on the map was a very perfect example. He was impressed. His cousin's husband was impressed, and he told him, he gave him a suggestion that you leave everything and you join the course of architecture, because in future you will become one of the best architecture. Okay. He went to meet the principal of the college. Now he went to the college of architecture. He went to meet the principal of the college. The principal warned me, I will allow you to take part in the entrance examination, but if you do not do well, I will not allow you to join. The principal had seen his marks, and when the principal came to know that he had scored only 50%, so he could only tell one thing to Hafiz. He told him, okay, I am going to allow you to give the entrance examination, and if you will get good marks in the entrance examination, only then you can join in this college of architecture, otherwise you will not get. I got an A plus in the entrance examination, and from that day it was a cakewalk. Now children, he gave the examination, and see, definitely he was a genius person. He got A plus in the entrance examination. Okay, he got A plus in the examination, and from that day it was a cakewalk. Cakewalk means something very easy to achieve. Now he got admission, and now it was easy to become an architecture. I had never made a plan, but I knew how something looked like from the top. Now children, like other architecture, he never used to sit for hours, think and draw map. He used to think suddenly and he could draw a map. That means it was a natural thing in him. Okay. I had never known what a section was, but I knew if you cut a plan, what it would like. Children, like others, they used to draw various sections, like the terrace, the washroom, the kitchen, the veranda, the patio. Okay, but he simply used to cut a plan that the how the whole house should be planned and look like. I stood first class first throughout after that, and children, the college also, throughout the year he got first class. I believe that all this understanding came from what I used to play and do during school. Now children, he knew that his brain had become sharper due to the thing, the planning and all the thing which he used to do in the school. I had a friend called Behram Divicha. We used to have competition between us for designing forts, guns and ammunition. Then he remembered a friend, and the name of that friend was Behram Divicha. Both of them used to have competition. Both of them were good in drawing. So sometime they used to design fort, sometime they used to design guns, sometime they used to design arms and ammunition. Each of would design something in an effort to be different. And children, in an effort to win, they used to design something different. They used to design something very different. In school, when I was in second or third standard, one of my teacher, Mrs. Gupta, saw my sketches and told me, "See, you are useless in everything else, but your sketches are good. When you grow up, you become an architect." I did not know at the time, but she was right. Children, he remembered during his school days, when he was in second or third standard, one of my teacher, Mrs. Gupta, she saw his sketches. When he used to have competition with his friend, okay, what was the name of his friend? The name of his friend was Behram Devicha. When she used to see his sketch, she told, your sketches are good. So when you grow up, you become an architect. I did not know at that time, but what was the meaning of architect? But she was right. She has judged him rightly. Later, after I became an architect, I went to meet her and tell her. Now he told me, when I grew up, when I became an architect, I also went to her house to meet her. And I told her that what she used to tell when he was a child, and her wording has come true. Now children, with this, I end this part of the video here. Thank you for watching the video. Please go through it. Thank you and have a nice day. Bye-bye.